This month, the Ask Paul question is, how far under a tire does a skate need to be? In order to help, we decided to set up a little skate demo to help answer this question and also show some of the obstacles that you face when skating a vehicle. This information is meant to promote industry best practices by towing and roadside industry professionals. This information is not intended to serve as a substitute for a company's own training, experience, or judgment. It is the viewer's job to evaluate the accuracy of any information found here. So, Paul, how far under the tire does a skate need to be?
So, Mike, that's a great question. And as always, you know, we always get a lot of good questions here. But the one thing about skates that people misunderstand is how to properly use them. And it starts with that skate being fully underneath of the tire, locked in with the head or the chock against the tire to keep the skate from moving back and forth, and also to keep the friction or the torque against that head in order to move the vehicle as one piece, being that tire and that skate slide together at the same time. So halfway under or quarter way under, it doesn't work. They have to be fully seated and locked in place. And you do that by getting yourself a nice dead blow hammer or a bead blast hammer and driving that skate all the way underneath there. I recommend those type of hammers because they have a little bit larger head, but they don't also break the end of the skate. And if you were using a metal hammer or a mini sledgehammer and you came back and hit the car, there's a chance that you might damage the car. So sometimes operators will try and put some kind of lubricant between the tire and the skate, or between the skate and the terrain. And what that can cause is for the skate to continue to kick out each time you try and move it. It needs that friction and it needs that resistance to bite and lock in together in order for the skates to perform and slide smoothly. So another area in which operators have a problem is the transition between the terrain and the bed, and trying to skate a vehicle up on there, depending upon, you know, how tight that bed is to the terrain, can cause the skate to bite in against the edge of the bed and either crack or break, catch really hard and jerk upwards, or kick the skate completely out, shooting it out the backside of the tire. So a couple ways to overcome this is to get, you know, a small piece of wood and trim down the edge and lay it at the edge of the bed so that the skate will slide right up that. There's skate ramps that are made, and that's a composite piece that locks into the end of the bed and it has a super smooth edge on it so the skate will slide right up it. So kind of whatever you can use that will eliminate the resistance and the angle factor of the skate sliding up to make the transition will make it go a lot smoother. So one thing to remember is that the angle of that bed will help the skate get started. However, sometimes you may have to walk the vehicle off utilizing the bed. So that would require you to, you know, extend the bed out, slide the bed forward, then roll the vehicle and the bed back a little bit more and work your way to get that bed right out from underneath the front end of it or the back end, however you have it loaded. But the reality is that it's no different than unloading with a shed or a piece of equipment or something where, you know, that shaking and jerking motion is not, you know, beneficial to getting it off there. The reality is that if you were able to just walk it off, set it down, slide it forward, pick it up, slide it back, and then bring it out from underneath of it, it'll help solve the problem a lot easier. Ultimately, if you want to be an elite operator, you need to have an understanding of all the equipment that you use, especially skates, as more and more manufacturers are going to require skates due to their electronic parking brake systems. And the more electric vehicles that come out, the more you're going to be skating vehicles. You're going to need to know how to use skates safely and properly.